my name is Kevin. I enjoy fish tanks, music, and video editing. I recently picked up the 65-gallon aquarium from Aqualand and will show you how the setup went, followed by an update of the 150-gallon Discus tank where we added 36 new cardinal tetras. Do enjoy and subscribe and turn the notifications on for monthly videos.
Well, look at this. We got another tank. I measured it out right. It will hopefully fit in that little spot there. It's a 65-gallon Marineland aquarium. It's kind of an odd shape.
I did some extra research on standard aquarium sizes with the hope of maximizing the space that I had, and the 65-gallon 36 by 18 by 24-inch tank would be perfect. And to my amazement, Aqualand Aquarium Center had this tank in stock in their showroom. Okay, enough of the extra narratives.
And so I need to rehome this guy, Francis. So the plan is to paint it black. And just to have it be bare bottom and very, very kind of simplistic, and showing that sometimes you don't have to do much to have a nice aquarium.
So yeah, this is kind of a crazy spot. This is like where you put your television, you know, in the 80s when it was those big box, you know, TVs and stuff. It's nice. There's actually a hole pre-drilled into the wall here, so I might like run air tubing and stuff through there and have the air pump inside of that cabinet where it's a little bit quieter. Here we have a shower in the bathroom, and we're going to clean this tank out. I'm able to sluice everything off. You know, it's better than it was.
All right, well, we got the tank on its side, and we're going to paint the back of it black.
No colors anymore.
Okay, so here's the tank after one coat of black ceramic coat acrylic paint. It's not totally opaque yet, so we're gonna put on a second coat. You gonna paint?
Yeah! Paint party!
Pretty good at that. You got a helper with the edges, doing precision work here. Excellent job. Okay, we're working on coat number three here. All right, looking pretty good. Nice and uniformly black. I'm a three-coat kind of guy. Hey, mister, we're filling up your home over here.
Tiny bubble.
Wow, man, that's crazy.
Make me warm all over.
So we have the Marineland 375 power filter, and so I'm basically just kind of stuffing it with these filter pads. And so that's going to grow our beneficial bacteria on it. All right, we got the filter up and running. Got the water flowing. So we'll probably see if I can put a pre-filter sponge on that. Otherwise, maybe just some filter floss in that guy there. And yeah, I'm going to turn our heater on in a minute to get things going. So we're going to add an air pump and a bubble wand to this bad boy. And yes, I did sleep with a bubble wand last night. So in order to get that piece of wood into that tank, there's no way it's going to fit in there. So I'm going to have to lower the water level again, make it light enough so we can kind of move it around and get that sucker in there. In the corners, we're going to kind of put some dragonstone, and then in the corners fill it in with this fluorite substrate, and then have that piece of driftwood in the middle, or otherwise it'll be a bare bottom tank. So there you have it, the piece of wood is in the fish tank. So we're going to fill it up with this tank water. We're going to do a recycled water change. So we're going to take a whole bunch of water from here, stick it in there. I'm going to add a little crushed coral to the fluorite black substrate, mix it together. So that's halfway done. That's the left side. So yeah, that's what it looks like over here on the right side. So we're going to put in a little bit more of this substrate over there. Yeah,
So what's nice about this tank is, yeah, it's going to be kind of bare bottom, but you know, there'll be areas that can hold beneficial bacteria a little bit better than just basic bare bottom, which, I don't know, I think is a pro. And yes, we'll have some plants there, some probably some corkscrew valve going up on the sides there for the kissing grommet to eat, and yeah, and then you know, if we have plecos, they'll have wood there to munch on, and yeah, that's kind of the thought behind that. So I'm not going to film this part, but I'm going to do water changes with manual siphon here and into these buckets, and slowly fill up the tank here. Alright, so you just do that until you fill it up. Got a little ways to go. So all the water that's in here is recycled tank water from this bad boy, our big tank. And so this is one of the benefits of having a big tank. You can steal some of the water and start a new tank with it. Even though, like, the filter media and all that is brand new, you know, at least there's some bacteria in there. So I'm going to put some test fish in here when we fill this up. So we found 5 rummy nose tetras, the first inhabitants of this tank. It's just a little foggy. Once they start pooping, then we officially start the nitrogen cycle.
Ooh, that looks good, guys, huh?
Yeah. Alright, the latest installment in the band cave is doing pretty good. It's starting to clear up.
I picked up these green tiger barbs to help cycle the tank.
Look at these guys. Look at that green color that you guys take on. Man, are you gorgeous. Like, seriously, it's ridiculous. And then up on top here, I'm using like plant weights to kind of hold like the air tubing, the black aquarium co-op air tubing. There's another one over there. The other thing I did is I pulled the intake off here, and I replaced it with a pre-filter sponge, the pre-filter sponge from Aquarium Co-op. You know, it's got that nice coarse filter, and so you have to pull that off and squeeze it every once in a while, but that adds extra surface area for beneficial bacteria to grow and benefit you, green guys. So I ordered a bunch of corkscrew valve from LRB Aquatics, and didn't really look at the extended forecast when I hit the go button, and of course it's February, and we're in the middle of sub-zero temperatures here in Minnesota, so they have not come, and I'm glad that they're still sitting in his tank in Indiana, so it'll hopefully get here safely. So anyway, eventually we'll get that corkscrew valve in here, and things will be looking good, and move these guys over, some of these guys over. But yeah, they're getting big, so we could do that 150 update right now. But yeah, this tank is doing good. The big thing, I think, would be that we added these cardinal tetras from Tamed Waters. Supporting the Amazon rainforest. The habitat where these guys live is going to be destroyed. So buying these actually helps the conservation efforts. They're so cool. Super into the cardinal tetras right now. Looking nice. Love this tank with no light on, with just the sunlight shining in. The Discus are always scared in the morning. It's a Discus and headlights. Oh wait, no, it's just the sun. He looks like the sun right now, kind of, sort of. Like he's the light source. Natural lighting. Sunlight coming in there doing that. See the rainbow in the fish tank? Rainbow in the fish tank. Rummy nose tetra silhouette. Far out, man. Guinea pig watching those fish.
Daddy.
You watching those fish? Thank you. So here we have some frozen Daphnia to feed the cardinals.
To get it to them, I kind of come back here and put it in this slot here. It's right there, a little over here too.
Kind of see it entering in there. There they are. Now they realize it's there. See that big chunk floating there? They're gonna come out and get it. There they go. Anyway, yeah, so they eat. So that's how the cardinals eat. And here's a 29-gallon update. Sorry about the leprechaun on my daughter's tank here. But yeah, this is the pencilfish tank. It's doing good. And so we added these diamond head tetras. These guys there. Got those from Tamed Waters. They're really cool. They just add like this nice splash of color in here. It's a bit overgrown, I must admit, but I love this tank. It's nice and chill, and these pencil fish are just amazing. Got the zucchini out. Panda cori back there. Got our green laser coris back there. Going out of focus.
Like okay.
So I was like, get away from my entrance. You may not come in.
Floating zucchini. Just above the Pleco cave. You know, they've eaten just enough of it so that it floats, but there's just enough snails on that it still sinks. It's quite precarious. But somehow it's perfectly balanced. Just the right amount of snails for it to float. Alright, we're going up into the Java Fur now. Let's get serious. It's like a beach ball at a sporting event in the crowd.